Procedures in adjusting the KTM Duke 390's headlight aim can be found in your service manual. But if you're the type of person just like me, who doesn't really read service manuals, then this video is for you. Tara, join me as we adjust the KTM's headlight DIY style. So hello guys, this is me again, BossTL at your service. If you have been following my channel, this is my second gen Duke 390. And one of the good things about this bike is how good its headlight is. Driving at night, you got this wide throw of light and a very sharp cutoff. Unfortunately, when our bike was recently serviced by KTM for a warranty job, they had to remove the headlight. Somehow after that, the light cutoff was not back to its usual. The headlight seems to be not properly aligned with the headlight aim, somehow a bit high. Medyo nakatingala siya. Likewise, if you would observe, the weights of the rider and passenger combined somehow affects the throw of light of the headlight. Just imagine this bike as a fulcrum with the weight of the rider on one end and the throw of light of the headlight on one end. The heavier the weight on one end, this will cause the headlight aim to rise proportionally. Kaya when I was riding with my wife as a back ride one time, yung cutoff ng headlight beam is already at the top of the bus, some 30 feet in front of us. Just imagine how much glare that would be to incoming traffic, right? For sure, sobrang nakakasilaw yun. This bike definitely needs a headlight adjustment. Okay, how to adjust your headlight's aim can be found in page 183 of your service manual. In adjusting your headlight aim, what you need is about 6 to 7 meters of unobstructed horizontal area with a vertical wall on one end. You park your Duke 390 with its headlight exactly 5 meters from the wall. Measure the height of the center of the headlight and mark the wall with the same height measurement as that of the headlight. From that level, measure about 5 centimeters below this line. And this new line should now be your reference where your headlight cutoff should be. Now, how to adjust the settings of your headlight. On the top middle part of your headlight assembly, you will find this adjusting screw. All you need is to turn this screw with an Allen wrench available in your toolkit. Turning the screw clockwise, that will cause the headlight cutoff to rise. Doing the opposite, meaning turning the screw counterclockwise, this will lower the headlight aim instead. That easy. Andali lang, di ba? However, always remember to adjust the headlight while it has its usual payload. Meaning, habang nakasakay ka and with all your weighted accessories attached. If you intend to use your bike with your back ride all the time, better to adjust your headlight while your passenger is seated on your motorbike as well. Andali, di ba? Well, unfortunately, not every time can we find a horizontal floor area spacious enough to conduct this activity. It is just too difficult to find a level flat surface you could do your adjustments on. And in many cases, unfortunately, we need to do the adjustments on the fly. Lalo na kung may bigla ang sakay tayo na backride and we see the headlight aim rising too high that we needed to adjust the headlight arbitrarily. Doon pumapasok ang recoil and gut feel. My technique for this one is to imagine a car 30 feet in front of you. Your headlight cutoff beam should not be lighting up the windshield of the incoming vehicle. For this case, for example, it is a car. Kasi you know that once umabot sa windshield yung cutoff, the driver is already being blinded by your lights already. So in short, approximate the level based on logical approximations. Alright? So this is the regular cutoff for the bike. So the problem with this bike is pag may back ride ka, umaangat-angat siya. So to adjust the headlight using the Allen wrench nakasama doon sa tools mo, counterclockwise as you could see, we'll move the, you know, the cutoff down, then rotating the screw clockwise, you are actually moving the cutoff up. You're moving the cutoff up, so makikita mo din sa wall doon, tumataas siya. So kung ganyan kataas, kung ganyan kataas na hindi ka nakasakay, pag sumakay ka na, tataas pa yan. So that would actually cause glare doon sa incoming traffic. So ang gagawin natin, bababaan pa natin siya. So to make that cutoff lower, actually rotate the screw counterclockwise para medyo bumaba siya. Ayan, you could see the cutoff going down already. So testing natin, pag nakaupo, medyo mataas pa siya. Medyo mataas pa siya. So bababaan pa natin ng onti until such point na tipong pag nakaupo tayo, dapat yung ano, cutoff niya, hindi siya nakakasilaw from 30 feet in front of you. So bababaan natin yung cutoff. Testing natin, pag nakaupo, shouldn't be. So adjust natin onting-onti na lang. Yan. So pag nakaupo tayo, that's good enough. From 30 feet going forward, 30 feet in front of you, oncoming traffic, hindi na siya masisilaw. Alright, so that is how you adjust the headlight beam of your headlights in a Duke 390. Alright? Alright.